Get ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Conrad, Janis, Brett Summers, Paul Williams, from Harper Valley PTA, Edie McClurg, McLean Stevenson, and Debralee Scott, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Could we get a tight shot of this? You know how I feel about
that. That won't work because it's a magazine picture and it's beautiful, but I...
This little fat baby...
All right, we'll try it, but I don't think it's going to work. I'm going to lay it
right
there.
Oh, he's so adorable.
And hope it'll work. Well, there's the baby.
That's me on the right, the baby on the left.
Oh, I'm going to cry. Don't play the music on top of the baby. You know how I get. I love babies.
Christopher Cole, eh?
Yes, sir.
What's he going to grow up to be?
Going to call him Cole? Going to grow up to be a porter? I don't know.
All right, let's welcome David Rhodes and Julie Vaughn here. Now, let's briefly review the story of your life, David.
I work for an employment agency, and I I'm single, and I live in Long Beach, California, right on the beach.
All right, and Julie lives in Hollywood, right?
No.
She's a hairstylist who works in Hollywood.
Who works in Playa Del Rey.
Oh, Playa Del Rey. I knew there was something about hair in you. Why do you have that star that says Hollywood?
Because it was a birthday present.
Oh.
Is today your birthday?
No, it was earlier in the month.
Okay.
All right. I thought
you was a sheriff. What's your sign?
What's my... Please.
Sure.
Yesterday, I'm sorry.
Anyway, she's got $250, won the first game. And now let's see how this game goes. We're in the middle of round one. He's had his question, matched two of our stars. And Julie, this is for you. And it says, Tim said, this town is really tough. I just saw... I just saw a bumper sticker that said, honk if you love blank.
Tough?
Tough town.
No, I'll go with the one you said to go with.
Tim said, this town... is really tough. I just saw a bumper sticker that said, honk if you love blank.
That's a good question.
Is it a good question? You like this question? Good. Why don't we give her this question? She likes this one. She can have this question. You want? You want to read it?
No.
Have you got an answer?
I'll have to say guns.
Guns? Honk? If you love guns? Tough town? Well, I don't know.
Guns are
a number of other possibilities.
Guns are tough.
Yeah, sure.
I said mugging.
Honk if you love mugging. Right. What do you got, Brett?
I said honk if you love killing.
Could have been honk if you love dental work, honk if you love barbed wire, honk if you love Hitler. That's sick.
Aha! Yeah, it was, people, you know, nasty, undesirable, terrible people like Hitler. Those, that's acceptable for that. I just saw a bumper sticker that said honk if you love...
Hell's Angels.
Aha! Tough.
I just want to go on record to say that I'm opposed to all of this.
Violence.
Too much of it.
Too much
but
violence.
On the good news side,
yep.
We got word from a small station, K-R-O-K, that's Croc, located just behind the Hearst Castle outside of San Simeon, that they are definitely interested in David and in Julie. They will be down tomorrow for a possible on-camera audition.
How wonderful. Yay! Very happy for them, David and Julie. We'll make a wonderful team.
And two shows from now, we can let the folks know how it turned out.
Sure.
Okay, now back to my answer.
Right.
And just in time.
Violence.
Violence. Honk if you love violence. What do you say, Debralee?
Stupid. Bondage.
Honk if you love bondage.
I don't know. It just came to me.
Honk, 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 honk.
Beep,
beep.
Honk.
Gene,
honk.
You know why that answer came to her?
Honk.
Because she's looking for a new boyfriend. She wants one that's just like the last one.
Yeah.
Bondage.
He took
all
the whips.
Well, maybe if he wins enough money here, David. And I...
Let's see, it's 2-0. David, you have to go first.
Eight
is, all right. Sid said, now I've seen everything. I just saw a movie where Minnie Mouse goes blankless. You don't play? We don't play. You play.
I play.
it said, now I've seen everything. I just saw a movie where Minnie Mouse goes blankless.
Braless.
Braless. Minnie Mouse goes braless. I always thought she was always braless. I never saw her with a bra on, did you? She Minnie Mouse with a bra on ever?
Well, Brett was right. She gave me that answer, but I didn't take it. I said Minnie Mouse goes tailless.
Tailless. All right. Just saw a movie where Minnie Mouse goes whatless, Edie.
Oh, am I telling?
You're telling.
La, 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 la. How come I only got three fingers? Topless.
Topless.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
La, 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 la.
All right. He's up to three now.
I copied from Edie, so came up with topless, obviously.
Uh-huh. He's up to four now. Honest men are hard to find these days.
That's for sure. I just... Never mind. I did not copy.
You
but
did.
I came up with topless.
All right.
I'm looking for a rich man.
Will you stand by for yours? We got a little business with America, and then we'll see how you do. Here we go. Julian, you have five to tie and six to win.
But stay loose.
I'll try.
Have you heard about the game show that takes place in a cemetery?
No. Oh.
It's called the Newly Blank Game.
Debralee, my...
They'll perk down.
What's going on now?
Have you, Julie, have you heard about the game show that takes place in a cemetery? It's called the Newly Blank Game.
The new... The Newly Dead Game.
Everybody's getting hysterical all of a sudden.
I don't know.
Madam, are you feeling hysterical?
It's funny.
Oh, all right. What'd you say?
How many does she need?
She needs five to tie and six to win.
Oh, boy. Well, I said dead.
All right, that's one. Five, you won the score.
Due to the fact that I have limited artistic appeal, I put the fact that there was that actually was a coffin. And I did say Dade.
All right. Two for Julie, five to two the score now.
My guest today is Lieutenant Rick Bouvet of the Monterey Police. He's chief of detectives up there. He's just informed me that he'd be very happy to whip some serious bondage on Debralee if she'd like.
Dead it is. You didn't hear that.
No, I didn't.
He just had a bona fide offer for you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Talk about it after.
All right.
I wouldn't lie about it.
Oh, good.
It's a new game show that takes place in a cemetery. It's called the Newly Blank Game.
I'm gonna live, live, live until I die.
Well, we've certainly got ourselves some show here, haven't we, sports fans? It's four to four.
That's
I'm
right.
I'm sorry. I was... Oh, give me some hammer time, Gene. You're here every day. Your little pink outfits and your silver ties and stuff. I'm sitting here in a dippy black sweater sweating to death. I want some time. Stay on me up there and don't go to Gene no matter what he says.
Stay on him no matter what. Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Can
you see the monitor? Look at the monitor over there. McClain, look to your left. See the monitor?
Yes.
See, they got your forehead. Okay.
Oh, great. Oh, that's good. The lace isn't showing. All right, now settle down, because this is big bucks.
Big bucks.
Okay, people all over America saying my
gosh. Now, you only tie. Dead.
Then it's up to Debralee and golly Ned's, who knows. I said dead.
All right. That's a tie score.
Now we have the show, sports fans.
Now,
all
here is the moment of
one.
Truth. As they say in Spain.
I'm sorry, I'm not going to tell.
Yes, you are.
Nope. Ira, how many?
We have to tie her up and beat her in order to get
dead.
Out of her.
Dead wins again. Well, we've got some prizes for David. We're going to send him some prickly heat and a stomach pump and all kinds of wonderful things. David, it was a pleasure to meet you. Good luck to you, sir.
Thank you.
Really? No kidding. Listen, Johnny, bring that chair in to me, the one that's sitting. Just wheel it, the one that Roger sits in. Bring it over here.
No, you don't. I'm kidding. I'm serious.
No, she's very nervous. and she's very tense, and I thought we just... It's a big step. Thank you, Johnny. You're very right. Just sit right down there as long as... I mean, I don't want you to be tense. Okay, now we'll go on here. No, listen. Here it is. Now, we poll the studio audience. You want to stand? I'm the star of the show, and if I say you sit down, you sit down. We polled the studio audience, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Lloyd. Blank Lloyd. Now swivel around to face the stars and call on them one at a time.
They're all looking at me. Okay. Debralee.
Harold.
Harold Lloyd. Harold, he was a famous Lloyd. Comedian in the 20s.
Okay, Paul.
Chris Everett.
Chris Everett Lloyd.
McClane.
Barbara Lloyd.
Friend of yours?
Frank! Frank Lloyd!
I went to high school with her.
Did you? She must have repeated. She was in my high school, too.
Maybe something will come from above. He has it. You have that.
Okay.
No, you sit down.
That was just funning.
Funning. Was Barbara was funning, yeah. Right. Well, everybody said she was.
Frank.
Frank Lloyd.
Right.
Yes. Right. Frank Lloyd.
Right.
Married to Barbara.
I don't think they got it. Give it to me one more time.
Your answer is Frank Lloyd.
Right.
Gotcha. Taliesin East and West. Now, you have Frank Lloyd... And Harold, no, you sit down.
Explain who Harold is.
And Chris Everett Lloyd. Now, you choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Okay, I will go with Chris Everett.
Yeah. Chris Everett Lloyd. That was Paul's answer. All right, let's see if Chris Everett Lloyd is under the $100 response. Frank Lloyd is there.
Right.
And the next one says, Harold Lloyd, famous comedian from the silent film days. And the top one says, Chris Everett Lloyd. Hey, very good. What's going on there? A little caucusing there for somebody? All right, get back in your chair. Now, you can play. Sit down. Sit down. Do what I say.
That's terrible.
Is she going to spin in her chair?
She can't spin in the chair, Gene.
She can't spin in her chair.
No, you spin
we'll
in your grave.
Let's just sit down. All right. Okay.
She has a mind of her own. I like that in the woman.
Fine.
Right on.
Now we're going to find out whether you're going to play for $5,000 or for $10,000. Have a go at it, and good luck to you, and this is it. You're playing for $5,000 with Debralee Scott. Here we go. Your job is to match her, remember? There it is. Blank shade. Blank shade. Oh, you're ready already? No, well, she's not ready.
Yes, I am. Ready.
Oh, she's ready. Okay. How do you match Debralee?
Lampshade.
All right, she says lampshade for $5,000. Lampshade's what she said.
Lampshade.
Is that your sister out there? Who's that out there rooting for you?
That's my mother and my best friend.
Aha! Well, congratulations to you. You got $5,750. Hey, Julie. Now we got a little message for you, friend. Thank you, Johnny. Let's welcome my two players now, Cynthia Walter and Virginia Schutz. Hello, ladies.
Good afternoon.
Welcome, and good luck to both of you. Let's find out a little bit about Virginia first.
Well, Virginia is from Wausau, Wisconsin, and that's in the cold country.
Cold?
Cold.
Yes. I came here to visit to warm up. We've had a very wet summer, and it's been lovely and dry here. I have one husband, three children, four grandchildren, and I'm very happy to be here to play your game.
Well, we're happy to have you here with us, Virginia.
I spend my spare time bowling, curling, snowmobiling, and skiing.
Where are you from?
Wisconsin.
Curling?
I'm curling.
Getting ready to go.
You do that on ice.
With the broom.
Can I jump in here somewhere? Rock.
Is this more than you wanted to know about Virginia? Right.
Sorry about that.
I have curled.
Sounds wonderful.
Curling is a marvelous sport. Freeze your blank off, but you're a lot of fun. All right, Cynthia?
Yes, my name is Cynthia Walter, and I'm presently living in Washington, D.C. I'm married to a med student at Georgetown, and I curl also, but in a weight room.
You what? Oh, my goodness. Holy mackerel. Can we get a...
Where is she?
Look at that. Wow. Can you do that with both of them?
Oh, sure.
Wow.
See the rest?
Yeah.
Get out of here. Do you really do weightlifting and all of that sort of thing?
Sure. You want me to pick you up?
Wait a minute. You can't pick... No, wait. I'm very heavy. Oh, my God. Holy mackerel. You got muscles there, too. Oh. I think you better get back up there before the panel, before McLean Stevenson.
Well, gravy Marie.
Yes.
Briminy Dutch.
My husband's in the audience. It's okay.
I've never met a lady who, really
I weightlift.
Wait, you who?
I do.
Really?
Yeah, I can bench, I can bench press 65 pounds. She probably is about 165, right? I can lay on a bench.
Sure.
Is that kind of...
Virginia, you want A or B?
B, please.
B. All right. Jack said my new gardener must have been a chef.
Yeah?
Instead of fertilizer, he's spreading blank on my lawn. Virginia, Jack said my new gardener must have been a chef. Instead of fertilizer, he's spreading blank on my lawn.
Tenderizer.
Tenderizer.
Yeah, very good. Uh-huh.
Good answer.
Yeah.
Good answer.
That's a wonderful answer.
Right.
I said tenderizer.
Tenderizer. What do you say?
That is a good answer, and Edie cleared out my sinuses because there's a little microphone under here. When she said, tenderizer, it's cleared right up. No, I didn't say any of that. I said hollandaise, because I'm
more cultured. Right, of course.
Because the lawn is a leafy green. I said dressing. I thought it was the intelligent
dressing
answer.
Uh-huh. Oh. Creamy Italian, is that it, Paul? Creamy Italian? Yeah. Or something like that? Quashnet? My new gardener must have been a chef. Instead of fertilizer, he's spreading blank on my lawn.
Well, I went the wet route, and and I misspelled it at the same time. Gravy.
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 Gravy. Sure.
How could we all guess that you might say gravy?
Gravy.
Hi, my name is McClain Stevenson. I'm from Bloomington, Illinois. I have one wife, 2.5 children. And in the winter, I enjoy catching colds, mononucleosis, and bowling. Do you know that where I came from in the Midwest, I thought gravy was a beverage until I was 17. Just to put it on everything.
Everything.
Needless to say, right. I was a bit of a chubette. However,
everything tasted the same.
Yeah.
Everything tasted...
Well, it was during the Depression, though. God knows I don't look that old. But it just covered up a lot of bad food.
Right.
Like, dried rabbit.
That's what they used to do.
Ew.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Sure. Okay.
Right.
Salt.
He's spreading salt on my lawn. Instead of fertilizer, he's spreading salt on my lawn.
This came to mind because fertilizer reminds me of pâté.
Pâté?
Disgusting.
All right.
And you
all right,
still
so there's one for Virginia. You'll have a shot at yours in a moment. Now this for you. Gene Rayburner, join us next time for the Match Game. Thank you all. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive Hush Puppies gloves for work and casual wear. Active men and women choose Hush Puppies, their hand's best friend. And Niagara is America's number one spray starch, helps prevent the deep penetration of soil and stain. A new Purina Moistened Chunky tastes better and now costs less than the leading competitor. Moistened Chunky dog food, better taste for your dog, lower price. And when you've got anything that sticks or squeaks, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it yourself with WD-40. A Mark Goodson, Bill Topman production. The program was edited for broadcast.